Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to our Duck Pin Challenge, being brought to you by the Connecticut and Rhode Island Duck Pin Bowling Proprietors Association. And we're coming to you from Plainfield, Connecticut, the highway lanes. I'm Norm Peters. This is Craig Self and Frank Ferry. And first of all, Frank, why don't you tell us about the bowlers representing Rhode Island today?
Manny Vitale will be bowling from Cranston, Rhode Island today. He carries a 131 average.
And Craig from Connecticut.
Mike Dominique, he's bowling out of Lucky Strike. And we also have a defending champion from Lucky Strike. The assistant manager is Bobby Dunnock.
Okay, very good. And we'll be back to watch our bowlers in action in just a moment. Stay where you are, please.
Duck Pin Challenge. Today we've got bowlers from both Rhode Island and Connecticut. We'll start off with Mike Dominique. Bowls out of Lucky Strike from Willimantic, Connecticut. Manny Vitale, Cranston, Rhode Island. And Bobby Dunnock, of course, our defending Comet. Bobby Dunnock bowled real well against Dennis Ponce a few weeks back. Let's see how Mike Dominique does. Does rather well.
Mike wasted no time.
He's enthusiastic.
Oh.
Nice start.
Here comes the head pin. Went about 18 feet to get there.
Yeah.
Took it out with a light end of the pin, too.
It's only 12 inches away when it started.
Oh, nice hit. Right in there.
Manny Vitale.
Oh, thought he had it. Manny went against the big boys in the roll-off. He only carries a 131 average, and he bowled against some good bowlers, and he made it. A lot of hot.
Bowls 2 leagues a week.
Manny's wife Mickey's in the stands. They got two beautiful children, Michelle 14 and Mark 12.
He's a store manager for Allmax Supermarkets. He's been a manager for 11 years.
Duck pin curse.
Yeah.
You can take out the head pin without hitting the one or the two on the sides of it.
Yeah, you left the 2, 4, 3, 6.
Last time we had a supermarket man on was Ray Cullen in 85. He won a trip to somewhere in the United States for himself and his wife by converting a spare jackpot shot of the 5-7-10 at the end of the show.
What a try. Okay, picking the wood.
Even with his frame, 20 in the second frame. Mike working on that strike.
Yeah. notice Mike, contrary to the other bowlers we've had on lately, he just gets up there, looks at the pins, and goes right after them.
He's so typical of the Willimantic Lucky Strike bowlers.
Is that right?
There's three families of brothers down there. There's the Dominiques, the Dunnocks, and the Drabecks. Now there's four Dominique brothers.
So if Mike wins this match, he's going to be one of his buddies.
That's right.
Bounce that ball.
What a nice bounce. What a good bounce.
Pulled out of that real fine.
We don't recommend that, but that was a good outcome for him.
He had enough on a ball to carry down. He dropped it right at the foul line that time. Nope. Right to the right.
Mike has a 4 or 5 step delivery.
There it is. All right, a lot of 10.
Reach right out at it. Now 49 through three frames for Mike Dominique.
High single game 220, high three game set 505 for Manny Vitale.
Manny down 19. This is a 10 frame match. The winner of this first game goes against Bob Dunnock in a 20 frame showdown. Two games, total pinfall.
Manny went too far left that time. Left up to 1, 8, 9. Try and chop it out. Oh,
he followed it right through.
That's the way you gotta hit it. He just missed it.
Yep.
Tough luck.
You get a fraction off center and the ball either hits it or the pin hits it.
No.
This guy's work cut out for him. He's 20 down through three frames.
He's got the stop mark.
He considers bowling a lot of fun, relaxation. He likes to concentrate and compete to win. Even though, you know, you have to compete, he says it's still a game to be enjoyed.
Can't catch a break here.
How far is Cranston from Jamestown, Johnstown?
They border each other. They're right next to each other, yeah.
And then look at this. Cranston's right in Providence, right next to Providence.
Right. Mm-hmm. They border each other. Manny loves this game. He wants to become good so bad. And he is, too. He might be a little nervous up there now.
He needs a little patience at this point.
He needs something to loosen him up. In the meantime, Mike's going ahead with his work.
Mike gave him a little break. He could have been working on a fill here in the third.
Up.
Got another spare break coming
nice
up.
Ball.
There's nothing that pumps you up more when your man is doing nothing. Mm.
The Battle of Willimantic, Connecticut against Cranston, Rhode Island. Mike Dominique, high single game 229, high three game set 533.
Yeah. What a competitor that man is. He's sitting there just rooting, clapping himself. He loves this game.
Appreciates good bowling, I see.
Yep. Never a bad word. Never. Always cheering for his competitors. Oh.
He has what you call, Frank, a pro attitude.
Exactly.
Okay, the 10 pin for this right-handed bowler.
Throw right at it. Yes. He's got a natural in-shoot.
We got hot and heavy bowling competition going here, and we'll be back with more of it between Mike Dominique and Manny Vitale in just a few moments.
Back to the first game. Manny Vitale down by 31 through four frames. Now's the time.
Go get him, you tiger.
Frank's cheering his man on here. There's a break.
Maybe his nervousness is gone if he had it.
You get a couple of breaks, you get over your nervousness real quick.
If he gets this mark, he'll loosen right up.
No. Held on to it.
Yeah, he held on too long. Well, it's a double pressure now. He knows he's behind. He hasn't got his first mark yet. It's kind of tough.
Get the pins.
Got a bomb back.
That's something to remember.
Take it any way he can get them.
A little life in that backdrop.
All right, Manny, come on now. Let me see you get one. I know he'd be awful disappointed if he didn't have a decent game, winning or losing.
What is it? If you're past the fifth frame and it starts raining, the game goes back to take the score in the fourth. This isn't a break.
Manny has a four-step approach, leading with the right foot. And he throws the ball basically from the first dot to the right of the center dot.
Come in light on the right-hand side of that five pin.
Maybe.
Didn't get up. Ooh, right. That was close.
Whoa. Nice try, Horse. Okay, I think Mike's going to have an overwhelming lead after this one. He gets a good fill here. Manny's going to have to start striking. You never know when that's going to pop up. You're going along so nice, then all of a sudden, bang, chop.
We've all been in Manny's shoes, so you go through six, seven frames without a mark. It's just you don't want to do it on television.
That's right.
Get a clean 10 out of that. The last ball was well executed.
Oh, boy. I wish we could have seen Mike on television then. After he released that ball, he jumped about 3 foot in the air.
And swung. Give it a punch.
right on.
Mike's a Pro Tour bowler. He belongs to the Pro Tour. He travels all over. Goes down to Baltimore, Virginia, up north to Lowell.
Lowell, Massachusetts.
He loves it. Good competitor. All right, Manny, let's get our first mark. Come on, you tiger, get it down.
I thought he had a home run then.
Get it down.
Manny's composite average is 1.
Come on, Manny, right on it now. Find myself cheering here, but. I'd like to see him shoot a good game.
He does not practice prior to a tournament. Prefers it that way.
Come on now, get it.
Good.
All right.
There you go. First one today. He's cheering for himself. He's got his arms up over his head.
Cheering.
Fans love him.
He's a good one.
They're all with him.
He's saying to himself, it's about time, Manny.
They're all with him. They know what's going on.
Look at a smile on his face.
This is a tough position to be
in. The whole thing was worth it right there for him.
Yep.
Now he's got to keep it together.
Yep. Come on, Oz. Come on. Yeah.
That away
he goes. There he goes. That's
here
my
he
man.
Comes. Watch the determination in this man.
Look at him go.
Okay. Move over, Marshall Holman.
He just said, who said I can't do it?
Oh.
Mike's coming back with his spares. Mike had a strike in the first frame, and he's been sparing just about every frame since, except the third, when he missed the one pinner. And in the sixth.
Yep. Right on.
Wow.
Likes that 10 pin.
Attaboy, Manny. Attaboy.
He's 120 plus in the eighth. He's 40 over, plus whatever he gets on the first ball here.
I meant Manny because he's cheering Mike on.
Oh, look at that. All around it.
Do you think he hit the ceiling there? Boy, did he leave
front things. Angle coming in here. Watch the man.
He gets way down, and then
he
comes bouncing up.
Yeah. Commercial time.
Oh, that's 3 foot. He's 3 foot off the ground.
What commercial is it? We see the guy leap? Well, let's not talk about it.
That's it.
Okay, Mike.
You know, he still has a good Manny shut out, really?
We're gonna, you know, if and it looks like Mike's got a bit of a lead in this match, but if we see Mike Dominique going against Bobby Dunnick in the second game, you're going to see two bowlers who really get down at the foul line. They start off and they bring that head down with every step. That's the way you want to do it.
Double.
Double. Manny's coming back. I spoke too soon.
Not dead yet.
Manny, if you can put 30 right. together in each frame, you got a real match
165.
Here.
He can end with 165.
He could potentially. He needs three more right here. He does that. He needs a double anyway in the 10th.
Come on, Manny. Come on, Manny.
Oh brother.
Oh, that
all
hurt.
Right, Oz.
He ripped his heart out.
Okay, Oz. Good try.
That hurt.
None to be ashamed of. Good try. First time on television. He'll be back.
He's enjoying it now.
Yes, all right.
Good try.
He's watching the scoreboard.
115, shooting for a 125 if he can get these last two pins.
Yeah.
And that's really coming some from being down five in the sixth.
Right. He was five pins behind his box in the sixth.
Hey.
That's good. And he winds up 25 over. Okay, Mike Dominique going to put him away. He already has, but he's going to add to it. Sanctioned event. You want to keep your averages up?
Yes. You know, all leagues should be sanctioned.
It really should.
Bowl the right way.
It's a minimum cost, and there's an awful lot that can be derived from that sanctioning.
The Bowling Congress sanctions all these events.
Keeps the game intact, keeps all of these promotional events, and helps the youngsters, and keeps the averages.
Okay, we'll be back in a moment with the second match.
Bobby Dunnick going to try to defend his title against Mr. Mike Dominique. Now watch this delivery, Frank. Watch how low he goes. He's right down there. It's the one error that a lot of bowlers make if they're, I would say, not averaging over 120 is the fact that they just kind of stand up at the line instead of smoothly working their head down a little bit with each step.
You know, believe it or not, your approach is the most important part of the whole, your whole approach. It's the approach, once your delivery.
Timing.
That's what it's all about, timing.
And you tie it all together with concentration.
You've got to get to that line the same way all the time. Yes. Oh.
Okay, we're looking at 20 frames here. The overall pinfall for two games to determine the champion. Mr. Dominique starts with a 10.
Two gentlemen from Willimantic, Connecticut. Oh, he bounced that ball.
Got away with it a little bit.
Yeah. He dropped it right at the line. That's when he don't extend himself. It seems when he doesn't extend himself, like you said, approach.
Could be he's thinking about the comet.
Mike Dominique won the first game, 156 to 125 over Manny Vitale.
Good shot.
Yes.
That's not an easy leave. Once you have that eight pin behind the two pin, you can leave that one by itself quite often.
That's a hot spare. He had a good shot there. Two good friends that are rooting for each other all the way.
Our prize money, $300 for the winner. The middleman gets $150. The last man gets $90.
Bobby's really improved.
Bobby Dunnick, two spares and two frames.
High single game of 235 for Bob, and a high three game set of 535.
We're operating here with a scorekeeper of our own so that we can keep pace with the game and know exactly what the scoring is. Young fellow by the name of Del Norman, first year bowler, doing a great job of keeping score for us.
Good job, Del.
Coming to you from the Plainfield, Connecticut highway lanes.
Good pitch, good pitch.
There he is.
Beautiful ball.
Yes, sir.
Here's another look at it. Nice.
Oh my, right through in the middle. You go through the middle like that and somebody will go, oh, you didn't throw the same ball. But geez, how accurate can you be?
That's it. You're talking about a fraction of an inch.
That's all you're talking about. Good 10. Good 10.
Well, Mike's down 15 plus through three frames. But keep in mind, this is a long match. Two full games.
Back right up in there. Oh, no.
Oh, look at that.
There
seven,
it is.
Ten.
That's the
tough.
Old 7-10.
How many times have you seen it made, Frank?
Oh, you can make this probably once out of every 40 times on average.
that's been good.
Is it? A little kind?
Being kind,
that's
yeah.
Being kind. I'll tell you. got to catch everything right. You got to hit it right on the outside. It's got to bounce down there and the rubber and come right back up. Or hit the cushion in the back and bounce that way.
You say there's a little luck involved there?
Most certainly is. But don't forget he had bad luck in it. It was a bad break.
And this guy here bowling now is a streak bowler. He runs off streaks of marks, probably 8 in a row, 10 in a row, whatever. So once he gets on, watch out.
In other words, when he's hot, he's hot, and when he's not, he's not.
Jerry Reed couldn't have said it better.
That's a good way to be, though. That's how you win a lot of tournaments.
You're right.
That's how you win a lot of tournaments. Outside, he's hitting them two pinners right in the middle. He's splitting them in two. Mike's sitting down saying, hey, I got to get going here. This guy's going to run away with this.
He's becoming a spectator.
Oh, what a beautiful in-shoot.
Oh, look at that.
Beautiful in-shoot.
Oh, what a way to sneak it out. Watch it.
Watch this head pin.
Watch the way this ball comes back. Look at that. Right into the pocket.
Yep.
Oh, it wasn't the head pin. It was
look at that.
Two pin.
We'll have more action here in the second game, the first match of the second game, in just a moment in our Duck Pin Challenge.
Okay, back to live action. While you were away, we bowled two frames each bowler. So in the sixth frame, Bob Dunnick had a spare with nine fill, and then he spared in the seventh. And Mike Dominique had a 10 frame and came back with a strike. And that's where he left off before on lane 15. He chopped the middle two frames ago. Five fill.
Mike will be trying.
Five fill, that gives him 67. In the sixth frame, he's trailing by 50 pins at this point.
We're being brought to you by the Connecticut and Rhode Island Duck Pin Bowling Proprietors Association.
Okay, Mike, you've got a lot to overcome here now. Got to get right back in your strike game.
He's got to start striking.
He had a strike on this frame last time.
Mike's a good bowler. He's not going to give up that easy.
Good try. Some of the duck pin bowling houses in Connecticut, Amity Lanes in Woodbridge, Arcade in Torrington, Cheshire Bowling Lanes, Cheshire Highway Lanes here, Plainfield, Holiday Lanes, Manchester, Johnson's in Hamden, Laurel Lanes, Winston, and of course, these two bowlers out of Lucky Strike in Willimantic.
I mentioned that that extra ball that Mike threw down the side channel there was to clear a pin sitting in there. It wasn't anything he was trying to bowl.
Some of the other lanes, Metro Bowl in Manchester, Perillo's in Waterbury, T-Bowl in Newington, Teller's in Middletown, Villa Rose in Windsor Locks, and Torrington in Torrington. Frank, are there any lanes over in Rhode Island you'd like to mention?
I'll chip in right after this box. I'll chip in right after this box. Oh,
that's what we saw while we were away. Mike Dominique had that same chop. That's a tough one. You're so close when you get that.
Ooh. Oh, look at that.
What a try.
Well, he strung seven marks in a row to start this particular game. Good nine.
Rhode Island Proprietors sponsoring this show, the Aquitnik Lanes, Middleborough Bowling Academy in East Providence, Dudek's Lanes in Warren, Hotside Lanes in Greenville, Legion Bowling in Cranston, right through the middle again. Max bowl away in West Warwick. Meadowbrook lanes in Warwick, Town Hall lanes in Johnston, and Wickford lanes in North Kingston, Rhode Island.
Have you bowled them all, Frank?
I bowled them all, one time or another.
I guess I can say the same for the Connecticut houses. I've got to get over to Rhode Island to do some bowling. So far, I've been limited to pretty much Connecticut and of course, the National.
Right. Help your participating proprietors.
We're going to take a side look at this one.
They're working hard to bring you this show.
So close. Mike's going to have to really put it together to get back in this match. He's going to lose the first game for sure, but he still has an opportunity to come back.
Look at that try.
That's not going anywhere.
There's Bobby.
Bobby's growing a beard.
Okay. Wrong guy.
Okay. Mike Dominique. About to finish up. With
there
a strike.
There he goes. It's just what he needed in that box.
Get ready
for the next string.
Have a look at this. I hope we can catch the jump. No, we're going to miss the jump. But we see the action on the pins.
That was a beautiful hit.
Needs a couple more of them right here. 10th frame.
Gotta take a tape measure to that jump.
Look at this.
Oh, here he is.
Look at this.
No jump though.
All right.
All right.
That's a little skipping action.
That'll give you a little charisma.
See, now he needs 9, 10 more. He's right back in here. He's only down 50 coming into this frame, but he's going to get 20 of them back, possibly.
Yes.
Oh, we had a jump there. Yes.
Oh,
what a great hit. Here comes the front angle. We're going to see the jump now.
Yeah, you're going to see it here. We won't see what the pins do, but you see him
all
jump.
All right, now. Up we go.
Up we go.
Right.
Hey, looks like some of those senior citizens I bowl with
it's
over at T-ball.
It's a bird. It's a plane.
That's Bobby Dunn.
Mo Tyrone, eat your heart out.
He's got every bit of that body moving when he gets that ball.
Okay, Bobby's going to be in the 150s to finish up.
If the highway lanes wanted to make a TV commercial, that would be a perfect, perfect
you
thing to take out and put into the commercial, that jump.
157.
Speaking of commercials, we'll be back in a moment after you watch a few as we go into the second game of match two. Bobby Dunnick and Mike Dominique.
Okay, the second half of this match. First game won by Bob Dunnick with a 157. Mike Dominique came back strong in the 10th frame with three strikes to close it to 127, 30 pins difference. And the Comet has struck again.
The Comet.
Replay here.
The Comet himself. Jeez, that almost looked like a chop.
He was so full.
Yeah. And he answered. Oh, look at that. What a hit.
Almost answered.
Jumping Mike.
10 pin. Solid as a rock.
The Willimantic Kids.
Yes, sir.
There he goes.
You realize that could have been four in a row? Really? Three? That was a beautiful hit.
That was a good hit. He was right there. He thought he had it.
Another one. Another one.
Oh, and he's got it.
Another one.
Watch him.
Okay,
watch his reaction as we give you the replay.
We're going to see the jump.
Look at this. Zowie.
All right. Yes, sir. The Leaping Dominique.
Good hit. It needs a mark now to answer Mike's.
Oh, he's a good bowler.
He's on.
I'm telling you, he hits that right in the nose.
Bob Dunnick has won the Eastern Classic in 1972, the Nick Tronsky Classic in 1980, twice.
The Eastern Classic's one of the big ones.
Tough tournament, 12 games.
Peter Pierce won it. Jeff Brands won it. Did you ever win it, Frank?
No, I'm close. I come with second. I think when Jeff Rand won, he broke a world record. I think he averaged something like 170-something.
It was right up there. It was 2,000 and something for 12 games. There he is.
Right on his Spears. There's only one thing that's going to beat Spears, and that's strikes.
Mike's got a chance.
That's all he's thinking of right now, a strike. And he might have it. No.
Back on that head pin full.
Yeah.
It's going to be a tough spare. Could be made. Right hand side of that three pin.
Try.
Beautiful try. Beautiful try.
Okay, Oz.
Good nine. 46 through three frames. Bob Dunnick, 48 plus.
He's been hitting this right lane pretty constant.
Yeah, most of his chops have been over in the left lane.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got that lane down pretty pat.
Nice little crossover.
He just didn't turn it. He waited for the alley to take it.
No.
Same thing.
Sometimes the 10 can be real tough for a right-handed bowler. Especially if you're trying to just go straight down at
it. Yep. Well, you were right when you said when he gets hot streak. He's right in there now.
I see it quite often with Bobby. Maintains his average in the mid-140s.
My streaks get shorter as I get younger.
Yeah, mine too. Of course, I started bowling when I was a lot older.
Oh, he fell. Stuck after in. He released the ball, though.
There was no foul. He kept his hands behind the line.
He probably got it. Okay.
So Bobby Dunnick's 11 pins up. Is that right, Frank?
11 pins and plus the 30 he had.
41.
41 pins.
With six frames to go.
Mm. Now, believe it or not, that ball there was from his last box. The last ball shot at the last box. He stuck. And when he went down just now, he feared he might stick again.
That's fear of what happened before.
That's why he threw a bad ball. But he come out with a makeable break.
Oh. Close went right around it.
Okay.
If you're bowling league, normally you'd stop and make sure you were not going to stick. He didn't want to take the time.
We'll continue on with the action in a moment. Why don't you watch these messages? Bob Dunick and Mike Dominique in Game 2 of Match 2.
Okay, while we were away, we had some exciting action here. Mike Dominique rolled a double, and Bobby Dunick came back with a spare and a strike, and the spare was something to see. He had a split where he crossed the six over to pick up the three over to pick up the six, four, and he got the six. But here we are on that double. The first ball fell eight. That gives Mike 83 in the fifth frame. He's leading in this game, but he's behind in the overall match. 83 to 76.
One hundred and one to 96
in the sixth. 110.
That was a big box for Mike. He really had a strike there.
He needed a strike there would have put him right back in this match. Now that he's way back now again because Bobby has his strike going in the seventh and can put as many as 10 on top of that. He could go to 116. Great try. Mike has to keep marking, though. You never know what can happen.
Mike Dominique. And Bob Dunick from Willamette.
Right on it.
Giving each other the high five.
Plus.
Friendly competition here at the highway lanes in Plainfield.
Bobby's in full concentration again. Yes, sir. Oh, right in back of it.
Should have had that.
Four pin one right in back of it in the round. Yes,
back in the answers over the mark. He's 116, so he's up 36 now in the overall match. Six pin lead in this game, 30 pin lead carryover, 36 pins. Two frames to go. Looks like Bob Dunick, Comet from Willimantic, may repeat.
Oh, it's tough.
Oh, look at it. Another strike.
There's another
Bobby's
look at
on
him.
Fire.
He sure is. Scorching.
Is that 1-3 pocket again?
Watch this.
Yes, sir.
Get down there, it says.
Oh.
Oh. What kind of action he doesn't need.
Mike put a lot of effort into that.
It was a good pitch. Like you said, a fraction of an inch. Good pitch.
Mike has 122 for eight frames. It's just that Bobby Dunick's running away.
Yeah.
A lot of nine.
131 through nine for Mike Dominique.
Okay.
Mike can go to 150 with a mark in the 10th.
That leap.
A great jump.
It usually
don't
means
take
a strike.
Out the six. Okay, leave that pen there. You need it for the spare.
It didn't get him the strike, though, that time.
No. It was a real solid hit. Pins went off the alley immediately. Yes.
You have to love his enthusiasm. He knows he's losing this match, but he's still right there.
That's the sign of a good bowler. That's the sign of a good bowler.
Bears down all the way to the end, even though he's behind.
He deserves a big hand.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, 150 game.
Nice baller, Mike. Nice baller.
Fans here love him.
He had a two-game total of 277.
Now here's the comet. He comes around every 2 weeks.
You got it, Mike. Frank, you got
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Accurate.
Yes, sir.
Putting on a clinic. 156 in the ninth, 166 plus in the 10th.
Possible 176. And now
almost had it.
75.
75.
We'll be back in a moment to make our awards. We'll be giving out the checks for the winners and the runners up in a moment.
We saw some real exciting and fine bowling action today. Time to congratulate our bowlers and to hand out their winnings.
Once again, I'd like to bring up Manny Vitale.
Yeah, you were wonderful in this show. It started off slow, but you finished great.
Congratulations.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Let me ask you something.
I enjoyed it very much.
Were you a little nervous in the beginning?
Yes, a little
okay.
bit.
Yeah. Okay.
But I enjoyed it. It was worth the wait.
Very enjoyable watching you too, Manny.
It was a good finish.
Okay. I wish I could have bowled a little higher, but excellent competition, and unfortunately, I didn't do well.
Speaking of the competition,
right.
Let's bring up Mike Dominic. Thanks, Manny. I love you. You jump. You jump so high.
It's just natural.
It was great to watch. We really enjoyed your show today, and you rolled 433 for three games. That's excellent.
Can we call you the Willimantic Jumping Bean?
Call me anything. Thank them for being here behind me.
Okay.
Okay.
Bobby Dunnick. Way to go, Comet.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations,
I need
Bobby.
All the help I can get with you.
Oh, you're doing something
you.
Else. You're really on your spares. That's great.
Yeah, throwing the ball real well. A lot of pressure on me. I think Mikey's probably one of the top bowlers in New England, young bowlers coming up, and we're going to hear a lot more from him.
Okay, thanks very much. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again the next time. Bye-bye, everybody. Thank you.